The fifth book of Madrigals is published in 1605, just 2 years after the publication of the fourth book. And that can perhaps be explained by the fact that Monteverdi has just been promoted to maestro di cappella, that is to say, the master of the music in Mantua. And so it's a time where he wants to establish his credentials as a serious and great composer. Monteverdi never sat down to write a book of madrigals. There were simply propitious moments within his career where to publish would be a good idea. And so at that moment, he would look back over the works that he'd written, the works in manuscript, and decide to construct a madrigal book out of those works. And we know that a lot of the works in the fifth book certainly weren't written between the publication of the fourth book and the fifth book. In fact, we know that because they're referred to by a man called Artusi, who's a Bolognese cleric and musician, who wrote a polemic criticizing Monteverdi and his modernities. He writes a polemic about what is wrong with modern music. Now, Artusi had as a teacher Zarlino, and Zarlino had written the book codifying how to write great music. Not just great music, but how to write perfect music. This is the time of the Ars Perfecta, where composers wrote music which was considered perfect, so perfect that there was no need for any further development in the history of music. Composers like Josquin and Gombert. But Monteverdi doesn't see music in the same way as those composers of the High Renaissance. Here, in the High Renaissance, music is to a certain extent abstract. But Monteverdi wants to write a music which is extremely specific, specific to the text that he's writing the music to. Not only each word of the text, but the emotional content of the text. And that's what differentiates Monteverdi's music from that of the High Renaissance. But Monteverdi permits himself to break all the rules in order better to express those emotions and the specific moment in the text. And that's what we're going to hear in Crude Amarilli. It's the very opening work of the fifth book, and it's celebrated not only for its beauty, but for its revolutionary character. The madrigal opens as Mirtillo is accusing Amaryllis of terrible cruelty. And as usual, when Monteverdi wants the text to be extremely clear, the whole ensemble sings exactly together, homophonically. And here, that little ay lasso from the soprano, that's the first thing that Artusi objects to, the clash between the C and the E against the D in the bass. And here again, in the tenors. I think for the modern ear, no one can be terribly upset about this. But for Artusi, it's the principle. The principle is that his teacher, Zarlino, has codified the rules in order that we have perfect music. And of course, if you break the rules of perfect music, you have imperfect music. And here we have some word painting with Monteverdi trying to illustrate this idea of the snake, the deafness of the snake, this frustration that Mirtillo has. And when we get to Fera, that's a tritone, a diabolos in musica, as it was called at the time. Diabolos in musica is the most astringent dissonance in the diatonic scale. And for Artusi, this is just impossibly difficult to hear. as the music ends, when he says, "In order not to offend you, I'll die silently," we have to remember that this is not a single madrigal. This is the opening of the fifth book of madrigals, but it's followed immediately by another madrigal. So we have Mirtillo speaking in the first person, and it's followed by Amaryllis replying in the first person. And so we have a conversation between two people in music. And that is, after all, the very essence of what music drama is about.